All right, I wanted to show you some of the workings of the paratrooper. So for that purpose, I'm actually going to use the German paratrooper. I'm not using the default gun because the default gun is the semi-automatic rifle G43. I've actually chosen to have the submachine pistol 34. Got a higher rate of fire, so that's really what I like to be able to do. I want to be able to really go for the capture points and then take those on. So I've got nothing else on extras on here except of course for the free fall badge on here. That means I can actually deploy my parachute whenever I want. So it's down to me to deploy it. And typically it's good to deploy it once you're around the level of the treetops. All right, let's go into a battle and let's have a bit of fun with this. All right, this is the loading screen, and we should see that we're based here on the attacking side. We can either attack from the east or the west, and we're facing the Americans. All right, so we are playing as the Germans and we're attacking the Americans here. I want to go for this capture point here. So they'll be using the Junker 52-3M, which is basically a transport plane. And the deployment takes a little while, unless of course you use certain badges here. I haven't got any of those badges, so I see that of course ground troops are already advancing towards A2. I would love to go to A3. And the first thing you get to see, of course, is your transport plane itself. At the moment, we are too far away. So, if you just look at my map, you should see that at the moment the plane is coming in from the east side. And as you see, it's basically over the drop point, is what it said. I'm not looking for this drop point, I'm looking for the other drop point. So, I'm just waiting for us to get near to their chosen drop point. Typically, about 350 or so, 350 meters is a good point to actually jump out of the plane. Now, I actually won't be deploying my parachute until I'm really close, which of course means they will have less time to actually shoot at me. Which means, of course, I'll be able to get indoors a lot quicker. Oh, took one out. Took over his gun. Because of course I'm using an enemy gun, I basically get specialization in that as well. And unfortunately he took me out. That was one of their paratroopers. Again, at this point I can actually choose to play a different soldier. I will stick with the paratroopers for now. And the benefit of being able to switch to a different type of soldier means of course if you deplete the supply of paratroopers, you still got another character to play. Preparing for another pass. I'd always say always look at the map to see where you are. So at this instance we are on the west side, it looks like. So the single chevron moving through the sky relatively quickly. I'm still going to try to advance towards the same capture point and 350 and jump. Again, I'm not going to open my parachute until I'm relatively close to the ground. As you can see, I've saw that there were some troops up in the loft of that barn there. And because of that, I'm trying to basically keep relatively close to where. Yes, I'm taken out. He was hiding in the corner there. Ah, and one of their troops was in the field and he took me out. Let's try that again. Or maybe better, yeah, I can actually try to go for that one here. Which of course means that they will have to move some troops there to of course keep me away from them. Ooh, actually, let's not do that. Let's do it. I want to back up these troops here in this particular point. Where did I jump out of the plane? Okay. Probably not where I should have jumped out. Alright, let's open up and let's go through these buildings here. Try to basically use the cover of the buildings here. Always useful. Now, I'm relatively far in the rear at the moment, so I shouldn't be encountering too many troops here, really. But that doesn't mean there will not be any troops at all. Now, I want to get to the front line relatively quickly. So how do I get there? Of course, I want to find myself some kind of vehicle. Typically, towards those spawn points, or the defensible points, you will find some bikes. So I'm going to look for a bicycle here. You typically will recognize that. Oops, it says I'm out of the combat area, which is not good. Ah, I was in an enemy deploy zone. I'm still looking for a bicycle or some means of transport. If I'm not able to find it, not the biggest issue. I will just have to do this slightly differently. There are some paratroopers coming out of the sky. Those are enemy ones, I would say. Always useful to have an anti-tank weapon with you. In this instance, the Shrek. Which there's nothing to shoot at here, so I'm just going to go down again. And I'm going to advance towards the A3 point. Ooh, transport train was shut down, it looks like. By our own Luftwaffe. Trying to use the cover here again. Always good to use cover if you can. Reduce the chance of the enemy seeing you, but again, you're kind of walking in the blind at that point. So there's pros and cons towards that as well. Hoping to be able to take them out with the anti-tank weapon, but that didn't work out, unfortunately. Would have been nice if I could, but next time I'll just use my machine gun. Now, ideally, I'd like to end up on the roof of one of these buildings, because typically a roof, of course, you're visible for them, but you can also easily sneak in some shots if you want to. And we're getting close to the chosen drop zone, so the word chosen here is really looking for. I'm gonna jump out. And that brings me relatively close, but not close enough. Open. Again, keeping that interval of jumping and then basically opening the parachute relatively close to the ground to as small as possible interval helps your survivability. In a crossfire being fired upon from both below as well as from the top, and I kind of thought it was one of my own troops at the bottom. Looks like I didn't look carefully enough. Just wondering how long this battle will end up being. Some of these will end up relatively long, some of them are relatively quick, so let's just see. Preparing for another pass, and this seems that we're passing on the east side, so it might be beneficial for me to try to jump onto C3 or C2. I think C2 potentially even. So we're passing by, and I'm gonna jump because it's close enough to the point. Trooper, or an enemy soldier at least, hiding in the bushes. Looks like he's already gone. This could be dangerous, don't watch it. Enemy airplanes can easily drop a bomb on top of your head. which is not what we're looking for. So I'm basically trying to basically support the recapture of C2 in this instance. Which of course means we need to get there relatively quickly before they capture C1. We're aiming to get C1 already, as you can see. If we can basically take out C2 before they capture C1, we are in the clear. The airplane weapon's always good, also against ground troops. Oops, and I got taken out by an enemy soldier. I was going for number C2, wasn't I? Now C2 is, I think, back in our hands. To try to deploy at C3 would be beneficial, I would say. So we're passing there, getting close, jump. Actually, I'm closer to C2 than I expected, but that's fine. As long as I still remember to open up my parachute relatively last minute. That'll meet my current requirements. I'm running bits here just to basically try to get into some of the cover here. Oops, ooh, just barely made it into cover. Sometimes you'll be able to find health deposits. Sorry, and he took me out. And one of the other transport planes got shut down. Now, is that one of ours or one of theirs? I'm not sure. Now, we got 118 paratroopers left, but only 34 transport planes. Then again, we got more left than they've got left. They've only got 91 paratroopers and 27 planes left. So jumping out onto the chosen spot. They got a numerical advantage here. I got him up, down, one of them down. Ah, he got me. I did wound him though. I did take out two and then damage the third. Okay. So in terms of my score, I killed only six. And I got killed seven times, it looks like. And I had three headshots. Okay, let's see what we can do. They're actually capturing. Oh, I'm on the east side. Really, really last minute parachute opening, but that's fine. I can live with that. O2 has been secured. Oh, cool. That of course means that on the west side that we basically have moved in nicely. So if we got O2, I should now be able to move on to the next point, which should be the X. Is that right? Ah, they've got paratroopers moving in to counterattack. Of course, I'm on my bike here, try to get to the front line to help defend that point. Now, I thought I could go for the X because I thought there was a point here as well. I don't see it at the moment, so I'm just gonna move get off my bike. Shot him in the back. Not too friendly, but it was necessary. They're still trying to capture the bridge. Lost the bridge, so I would actually like to move in to support the bridge. Trying to use some cover where I can. Very, very nice parachute drop, I would say. So as long as we keep this bridge in our hands, that's great. Say that's the ultimate, but at least there'll be a clear advantage to us. Try to defend it from this point if I can. Should be able to see anyone approaching the entrance to this building. I do hear someone reloading their gun. Which means they're either just behind me, or they're just around the corner. We're capturing O1 at the moment. Some paratroopers here, and he's trying to shoot me back. And I got him, but he got me at the same time. Okay. Happens. Okay, we are gonna go and defend this point further. Now, I could, of course, try to advance onto the next point, and I think, given the troop disposition, that might be a good idea. I'm gonna go for O1. Return to the combat zone, which I would love to do, and I'm entering an enemy deploy zone. Yes, of course I am. But I accidentally jumped here, so I need to basically make my way back. Now, how do I get my way back into there? I'm hoping to catch a ride from a vehicle. So if there's a vehicle in this particular barn, I could take that vehicle and drive, yes, drive into battle. This will take a little while. It's not the fastest vehicle, but it is still a moving vehicle. Allowing me to, of course, advance over to the battlefield. And we have lost the bridge. That means that any other points we are trying to advance towards are no longer in capturable state at the moment. So I'm just now trying to basically move myself towards this bit of the front line. There's a bit of back and forth here. That's annoying. That's really annoying. I got the impression I was being shot at. For that to be possible, there needs to be enemies here. Enemy soldiers, enough of them. Loads of them, I would say. Relatively high, but they took me out with a Panzerfaust. Do we own that building now? Yes, now we do. So at this point we should be able to secure O1. Now this battle is taking a bit longer than I thought it would, but that's not a big problem. As long as you're still watching, then that's fine by me. Alright, let's have a look at whether we can actually get into the selected or chosen drop zone. Chosen one, but I'm gonna drop anyways here. See if I can then maybe get into the church. That was a really late opening of the parachute. A big problem with itself. So I got hit, not sure by whom or by what. I don't really wanna find out too much about who or what. Looks like we got the bridge was lost again. Darn. And I took him out. That was a pilot of a airplane. Typically, it's a good defensive position where he's based at the moment. Let's try to support him on the bridge. I'm not sure they need it, but let's try it anyways. So really, at the moment, O2 is a choke point. If we're not able to hold O2, we're not able to capture our next points. Where did I just jump? Did I jump in a smart position? Well, maybe not. Relatively close to the church. Should I play it smartly? I could actually play it to my hands, because there is not only just one way up, there's actually multiple ways up. So I'll take these ladders and so forth to basically climb up onto the church. I should be able to do something about the fact that they were continuously defending that tower. Unfortunately, I just got taken down from below, which is not really helping me. Looks like the enemy is moving into A3 at the point. So really, if I were to be able to focus on O2, that would be ideal. We haven't got enough focus on O2 at the moment, I would say. So a brief look at the map where we are. We're at the moment northwards of our point where we want to be. Look at our reinforcement levels. We got 45 paratroopers left, and we got about 50 on the enemy's team. Jumping. I think I jumped a little bit too late. Ouch. And only because, of course, I was in there. Zone. Now, I think it might be beneficial for me to switch soldiers. So I might want to switch to this guy here. He's relatively good at being able to move into frontline positions, defend places. just see an enemy trooper here? I thought I did. Is he still here? Did he die? I'm not sure. Come on, I want to get my chauffeur experience up. that guy was still there. So A3 at the moment is in our hands. We're moving towards O2. Basement at the moment. Well done. I think we'll be able to take the point, but never entirely sure. Until of course we have tested it all. And I got shot, unfortunately, by a sniper. He gave it a very, very appropriate name to his weapon, I would say. Alright, so we're going to basically get ourselves another Kubelwagen. Oh, not hitting it too hard, I hope. You hit the wall too hard, it means you could blow yourself up potentially. It's always a thing to bear in mind, don't hit any of the walls too hard, otherwise it is treated as being a suicide. And we secured the point. I got taken down by an enemy soldier. Good spawn point here, just to the south, which was an enemy spawn point just before. Alright, last one to go, shooting him down. I should be able to see my, I think it's morale or health. We get back up to full level in just a second. What happens when you lie down without actually watching your back? You get shot in the back. I first off thought he was dead, but yeah, turns out he was only lying there to basically seek some cover. To bear in mind, when you're reloading, you won't be able to fire auto. But I think to bear in mind, you won't notice that basically my health bar is less long now than it was before. So some of the damage you suffer will actually be permanent damage. Some of it is temporary damage from which you can recover. In terms of the temporary damage, it recovers over time, whereas the permanent damage you can only repair with a health kit. So there's still a way of basically recovering that. It just it takes a bit longer, you need to find the right resources for it and so forth. So I'm trying to move into position here to help take the church. Ah, the squad leader now, it looks like. Again. It's a whole back and forth here all the time, isn't it? They're trying to take the bridge. Actually, they haven't taken it. They've neutralized it, but actually haven't actually fully taken it yet. And I kind of had wanted to spawn here on foot. We've accidentally spawned in a vehicle. It's not a major issue, it's just not really what I was looking for. At the moment, of course, in the car itself. Alright, I'm gonna move up. I took out the gun, moved into the gunner position earlier. I got shot down with a pistol. Alright, have we captured it or not yet? We're in the midst of capturing it, and I'm gonna go on foot. Now, I do not think we'll be able to win this battle. If you look at the base of the bar above the Americans, that is bigger than our bar. It's in red. And that, of course, indicates they are at an advantage towards us. They get it entirely full, which they will be able to get once we lose this objective. They win, basically, which is not what we're aiming for. So let's see where that soldier of theirs is. Is where he is indeed. Let's check that out again. Hiding behind the crates, reloading. Him down, took him down. Still hiding behind the crates, reloading. I know the reloading required at the moment, but they have seen me now, it looks like. So he's probably in the building here somewhere now. At least that's my assumption. Took him out, so defended our point, so there you get defense points for that. We were able to capture a second point, and we basically got another one of them in here. He's just down there. Took him out. Now I know there is a health crate over here. At least there used to be. Just when I need one there, health crates, there are none. So we have got two of the points now. I would love to be able to get a third. I suppose we get a third, we win. Taking into account their reload time itself. Ah, did I get him? No, I only wounded him, unfortunately. Sneaky position. So we're aiming to go for that one, but of course I have my various different spawn points here. I'm gonna spawn on foot here. This is relatively close to a church. Ah, I got shot. Where did I get shot from? And one thing I actually forgot to do here, really, at the moment, is I forgot to account for the fact that I'm basically a squad leader. And as a squad leader, you can actually start issuing orders. And I got him! Yes! He was in that building up there. Took him out. Lucky me. And he got me, unfortunately. But at least I know whereabouts they are hiding. Now, I'm not sure what is going on at the moment. For some reason, it doesn't let me do anything at the moment. Maybe that's the recording, so let's pause the recording and let's restart it. Alright, is there a bug in the game? I'm not sure. Let's see if I can change my trooper type. Ah, yes, I can change the trooper type. And now, yes, I can spawn again. So for some reason, I wasn't able to use the trooper type I had selected just a second ago. I had to go back to the paratrooper. Alright, keep an eye on the map as to where we are. Unfortunately, we have lost two more objectives, or at least one of them. Jump out, even though we no longer have direct access to it. I think it's still useful to be able to get into this tower here. Did I get him? Yes, I killed him. At least I killed him in the tower here. Ah well. Took out two, lost one. Can't get them all. Look at that. Look at that plane. Wow. It says near and drop zone, not my chosen one. It is a drop zone. Ah, and we lost, unfortunately. Anyway, thanks for joining me. Let's have a brief look at the after battle results. So in terms of the after battle results, what we see here is of course my paratrooper that I've been playing. I see the experience he's gained, but because I played a second soldier here as well, they gained in here as well in terms of experience. So you basically see their contributions all listed here, but you can basically cycle through all the soldiers that contributed. Hopefully you enjoyed it, and I will see you on the next one. Bye bye.